Stapleton here from bloggerbreakthrough.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a sales page inside of ThriveCart. In another video I showed you how I came up with the sales copy for the sales page using closer's copy. Definitely check that out. I will put a link to it, I think, here. If you guys have questions about that, let me know. But today we're just building the sales page in ThriveCart. So first of all, there are free ThriveCart templates out there. So this is a spreadsheet, and I'll put the link in the description. I didn't come up with this spreadsheet. I got it from the ThriveCart, I think, Facebook community. And there's so that you can import a sales page, so you're not starting from scratch. And there's a lot of good ones that I like quite a bit, because I find it's way easier to customize and create something when you're starting with something on the page as opposed to a blank page. If you're a designer, and you want to do your own thing, great. You can, ThriveCart has a great, like, drag and drop builder, which I will be using to customize, but I'm going to start with one of these templates just to give me something on the page. And I might end up completely changing it. We'll see. But all I have to do is copy this link. And then when I'm inside ThriveCart in the design part, I'm going to move my face here. It'll let me. I'm going to hit import a design and put that URL there. And there's lots of ThriveCart templates out there that you can purchase. Lots of people do that. There's nothing wrong with getting those either. I just want to show you kind of a free option. Well, ThriveCart's not free, but okay. So you can see it's loaded up everything. Already, I'm going to change the name. And I want that to fit, so I'm just going to shrink it down till it does. And the rocket actually like fits really well with this, so that's fine. I'm going to actually set my screen up to do a split screen. Okay, let's see if I can't close that out. That helps that side. Let's see if I can't help out this side. Okay. I'm not going to do a video. This testimonial that I will update with one of mine. So I want to break it up a little bit. Let's see here. We add a bit of a divider here. And then I'm going to actually duplicate this element because it's already got the settings I want. Put it underneath the divider and start grabbing some of this. So one of the reasons I like content box is because it lets you just kind of set it apart. You can obviously do, background image or border radius, border size, border color. So I actually think I might do that and then get rid of the background color and bump this up. We'll see how this looks when I'm no longer split screen. Okay, so. Actually want that to be probably more like this size. So I'm going to duplicate this. And again, this just helps keep everything consistent. I probably need to adjust these icons. I would assume, is this an icon? I need to, yeah, so it's a picture, so I'll need to get different ones. I'll skip that for now. Right, and now we're going to do some bullets. Actually, really want to bolt this out. Make sure these match as well. All right, so I'm going to keep going. I want to do something that really is like a call out. I'm not offering a coupon code, so I don't need that there. Also, I'm going to hide the ThriveCart. I'm going to add custom link. No. I want to add... here. There's a spot. Add, yes, terms and conditions. It's very important that you do include terms and conditions, because it just reinforces your rules and what they're agreeing to. So they are required to check the box in order to purchase. So okay, and I'm going to just change the color. I don't like that it's all different blues. All right, so I still will need to go in and adjust the testimonials. But I want to see, now I want to exit out of this. I want to see how this looks. Whew, still kind of some walls of text. So that's on desktop. Right, so on mobile is probably even worse. So let's just break this up. Actually, I think what I'm going to do is I don't like it centered. I think that's part of my problem. I think it's hard to read. So select all. It so it's not centered. This part so that it's not centered, but this kind of still is. Okay. All right. I need to adjust graphics and testimonials, obviously. I need to add more buy buttons, right? Because you don't want them to have to just keep scrolling. You want to make it easy for them to purchase. So we are going to add some buy buttons throughout. And what the buy now button does is it just jumps down to the order form. So, but I don't want them to have to go searching for buy buttons because that's just makes it hard. We want it to be easy. Okay, so far so good. I like it. I'm actually going to go ahead and put that further up. Where can I put it? No. Oh, I can't. Perfect. Okay, so I have to pause. I'm going to hit save and exit because I don't want to lose my work. And then I'll get back to it and creating the success page as well. Now, when you're working in ThriveCart, you don't just want to save that. You want to save the whole product, because I found that if you just save the page and you don't save everything else and you somehow get logged out or whatever, it's not always saved. So just taking it out to the beginning. And I will come back to finish recording in a moment. All right, and I'm back at it, and I'm going to edit and go make sure the success page looks good. Knowing that I still have to swap out testimonials and images, I just want to show you guys how quick and easy it is to build a like full-blown sales page, not just like a checkout page. So let's see what the success page looks like. Okay. Just want it to be all cohesive. Because mine's actually going to fulfill through ThriveCart Learn, so I clearly, my fulfillment settings is not quite set up right. Ah, here we go. So let me get this. I will adjust this, but next design launch. So that way I can actually get what the success page is going to look like. All right, I'm happy with the way that looks. So yeah, it took about 40 minutes. I think it took me about 40 minutes or so to create the copy. As someone who doesn't create landing or sales pages very often, I mean, I'm sure copywriters and designers do, and they're probably a lot faster. But someone who doesn't, like, something like this has previously taken me like an entire day and like having to take breaks because it's just hard. And I managed with Closer's copy and ThriveCart to create a sales page that I'm happy with. Yes, I've still got a few more tweaks I got to take care of in, you know, an hour and a half, which is just mind blowing to me, because this I'm going to edit this video down so that you're not having to like sit through me copying and pasting too much. I mean, you'll see it. It'll just be sped up. Or obviously, if you're at the end of the video, you've seen that it was sped up. But it took me about 40. The clock is just hitting 42 minutes to record this. Hopefully it's what you're watching is much shorter. But all in all, like an hour and a half from absolutely nothing to a sales page, designed and everything, I'm pretty happy. So hopefully you guys found that helpful. If you guys want to check out ThriveCart, they do have lifetime pricing currently available. It's $4.95. If you want more features, there's ThriveCart Pro. I think it's like $6.95-ish in there, but it's one-time cost. And it includes ThriveCart Learn, which is like a course hosting platform, so you wouldn't have to pay for Teachable or Putty or Thinkific or whatever it is you're using. That saved me. I mean, I was spending at least $1,000 on that a year. And so like ThriveCart that I bought a couple years ago and then upgraded to Learn Plus when it came out. So Learn Plus gives you some additional features in the course hosting side of things. Like just literally saves me thousands. And I've been very happy with it. I have recently been approved as an affiliate. So I will include my affiliate link to ThriveCart below, which means if you purchase through that link, that I will receive a commission at no cost to you. But I have been excited about and recommending ThriveCart for long before they approved me as an affiliate. So, you know, I would recommend this even if I didn't get paid for purchases through my link. So, yeah, hopefully you found this helpful, and the resources and links I mentioned are in the description. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments.